Dear students, let us see how to do this one. First of all, the rule of exponents. Okay, suppose I am going to say a raised to the power n and again multiplied by a raised to the power m. That means the powers are different, the bases are same. What is base? A is a base here, and what are the powers? For a the power is n here, and for the other a the power is m. So both the powers are different. So in this situation, okay, when the powers are same, okay, means when the bases are same, you just write like this a raised to, then you can add up the powers. Okay, so that's the rule. So the other one, if the bases are different, suppose I just say a and b, both are different and the powers are same, like n and m, then what do you say? Then it comes like this. Okay, we multiply the bases. Okay, then we put it as the power, we write it as n. Okay, so this is a rule. If I want to give you an example, 2 raised to 2 multiplied by 2 raised to 3, since the bases are same, I say 2 raised to 2 plus 3, that is 2 raised to 5. If the bases are different, then what do you do? 2 raised to 2, okay, and 2 raised to 2, both the powers are same, then what do you do? Multiply the base, so 2 into 3, then keep the power as it is. So the answer will be what? 6 raised to 2. So the 6 raised to 2 answer is what? 36. And this also, if you do it separately, what happens? 4 into 9, what is the answer? 36. See? So it works out. Okay? So using that thing, so when you get a problem, you keep the base as same and add the powers. That is one method. Another method is what? If the bases are different and if you see the powers are same, then you can multiply and do it like this one. Okay? 6 raised to 2. And another one option is there. If you see plus or minus in between the fractions and try to multiply and, okay, when the bases are same, okay, then the powers, okay, powers are common in between, when compared with on both sides of plus and minus, then we can take it as commonly out. That is the property we are using called distributive property. So that property can be used, and with that we can easily solve the problem. So these are the three main techniques used here. Okay, there can be many more. Okay, in this situation, see the powers of the see the base. The bases are same. So what do I do now? 1 divided by 2 raised to 2 plus 3, because both bases are same. So I am adding the powers. That is equal to 1 by 2, okay, raised to 3n plus 1. Now since the bases are same on both sides of the equation, we can strike off that one. So the next thing is 5 is equal to 3n plus 1. So what is the value of n? So 3n is equal to 5 minus 1, that is 4. Okay, that is 3n. So what is n? N is 4 by